As tri-state teenagers sweat it out, coaches have to be sun smart. And News 6's Brian Hamrick is live with all the guidelines schools are supposed to be following these days. It's our number two pick for you, Brian.
Well, Cherie, it's hot enough if you have to be outside on a day like this, but imagine those high school football players who have now gone to two-a-day practices under the helmet, under the pads, standing in the direct sunlight. Well, this is just the starting temperature. Covcath players are coming face to face with their most oppressive adversary. And this one hits harder than anyone on the field. It's the menacing heat.
You can't really catch a good breeze in the equipment. So it's really like sitting in a sauna all day running around on the field, so it gets pretty hot.
In fact, hot practices have become such an issue that specific guidelines are in place statewide.
The Kentucky High School Athletic Association has guidelines in which everyone in the state must follow. They're broken down into basically a heat index range with the temperature and the humidity.
And it's not just Kentucky. Ohio has similar guidelines too. We caught up with Withrow athletes today. If it gets above 90 degrees, water is available at all times. In addition, there's mandatory water breaks every 30 minutes. As the heat and humidity climbs, pads come off, too hot, and practice can be canceled. Athletes are weighed before and after practice, too much loss, they sit out. Still better than being knocked out by an adversary you can't see, but you can certainly feel. Now these days, temperature is measured together with the humidity to get an accurate assessment of just how hot it is out there. And there's a gadget that no trainer is without. We'll have more on that coming up at 6. Reporting live, Brian Hamrick, News 5, where the news comes first.